Hey guys, my name is Justin Strazzanti, and I'm going to show you how I made this. Hello everyone, and welcome back. Just wanted to just let everyone know, welcome back to the show. Today we got an awesome episode here for you. As mentioned, 24 hours ago we went through the paper mache material. We went ahead and glued it all together. As you can see, this is the masterpiece in which it is ending up being in doing so. Take a look at that beauty, why don't you? So this episode, just to complete the process here, is going to be a little bit shorter than normal, but it's going to be a lot more fun. First and foremost, you're going to need these metallic cords here, which I'm showing to you right there. Yeah, there you go. These metallic cords, we're going to wrap these cords around this beauty, and then after a day of painting with those corks I showed earlier, you're going to go ahead and paint them gold like this. And what's going to happen after is that we're actually going to go ahead and put it inside. So I put it outside the contraptment, and we're going to go ahead and put it inside as well, giving that very doom-like effect. A very, I would say, sci-fi effect. So, let's get right to it. I was doing a little test earlier in the week, and this is the exact, this height here of the string is it's the length which we're going to wrap around the strings like this. In doing so, so it's giving that vibrant effect. So we're gonna tie a string, get it wrapped on as tight as possible, as tight as possible. We have glue there as backup, but I don't think it would be needed. But if you like, imagine having multiple strings like this, basically surrounded by it. So we're just going to go ahead and unravel all of these here. And yes, this is 24 hours later again, because I did mention this project would take some time. This is a 2-day project. I just want to give everyone a heads up on that. So, let's just go ahead and proceed and just match the exact same length. We're not going to do anything more or anything less. Basically, you want to see everything matching up the exact same. Okay, very good. Yep, and then this process would follow through for the next one. By all means, you can always use the leftover string for something else. For example, you can wrap it at the top if you want, or you can wrap it at the bottom. That's a fairly brilliant idea, to be honest. To have the same cords, these are going to be cords, attached to the centerpiece. So just want to give everyone a heads up on that. And I am having trouble taking this out, but it's okay, we have all the time in the world. I'm not worried at all whatsoever. It's just, oh yeah, this guy's having a ball. Okay. And okay. One second. I didn't want to wrap this before. I wanted to give you that visceral experience. So, so let's just go ahead and take this out. One. So again, we're not going to do anything special, as mentioned. We're just going to simply wrap the string around the centerpiece, and then after you wrap it, just make as strong as a knot as possible. In doing so, and then from there, just remove the knots. Okay, so one, two, almost done. Three more to go, but we are almost done. Cretology really knows how to tie these together. My word. Considering there's all these layers. Well, I think they want to give you at least 21.9 meters of yarn, as they say. Basically, this is yarn, but it's metallic and it looks good, so yeah. yeah. Okay. It's almost done. Okay, there you go. That's it. Almost there. Just like this. Okay, so this process is going to be the fun part, actually. Go. Two more to go. Almost done. Basically, you're going to have a whole slew of back yarn remaining. Backup yarn remaining. Easily take it off. I think it is. I just don't want to ruin it. But it's yarn. I'm not going to ruin it. Can't destroy it. It's already been covered. Okay. And if you are joining us from all over the world, just want to mention hello. I am glad you are enjoying this experience, as you can create this too. Just want to give you a heads up, you can do this as well. You can use it in your own house. Same as I. Okay, almost done. Almost done. Almost done. So now, let's go ahead. And then, last but not least, we got our last one here. And, yes, the last one. Okay. So, after this process, you're gonna look at what you created. You're gonna be like, whoa, I created this. And you're going to be like, damn, I didn't know that I can do that. That's the whole point of this, is to show you that, yes, it doesn't matter what age you are, it doesn't matter where you're from, it doesn't matter what creed your background is, anyone can do this. Quite simple, easy, a lot of work behind it, but anyone can do this. By young, I mean like, yeah, you can be like 3 years old. That'll be, yeah, and doing this. You have to have an adult around, but if you're younger than, you know, let's just say 16, pretty sure you could do this. Just be sure that there is an adult around, to be honest. But let's just, okay. Okie dokie, so. Oh man, I got myself in a knot here. Okay. Oh, there you go. Okay, so, this is what you want, basically, is all of these onto this. Now you can go in line, you can go, you know, you can mix it up a bit if you want, but all you're going to do, oh, hey man, chill. So all you're going to do is just wrap it as if you were, let's just say, tying your shoe. Yes, tying your shoe. And you're going to do that whole, I'll just show it. So you got to go like this. Oh, where's your phone? See, that's the one thing, you position it in the, do you want the top? Do you want at the bottom? Do you want it like sideways? You know, it's completely up to you how you want that, but what I would recommend is that you either do it in a single knot, like so, or a double knot. So make sure you put that knot in as tightly as possible. I'm going to do a double knot here, if you can see it. And I'm going to do a double knot again, just in case. So you're going to end up with this, and so you're going to feel free to like remove that, so you can feel free to move it up and down, but again, it has to stay in the position as so. And then what we're going to do is just and voila! So basically you want to have this effect going through. So simply just do that repetition and yeah. Double knot it, and I'm gonna triple knot it just in case. Oh. Okay, we'll see. That did not go through as planned. So now I have to take care of. Birds outside. Okay, they're chirping. I haven't heard that in a while. Yeah, I'm gonna just figure this out momentarily. Cause that's what I do. Okay, so, as mentioned before, we can either do it at around this. I gotta make sure that it's tight. So you gotta make sure that, like, this, there's no end string just hanging there, because it's gonna end up falling like I just did. And then we're going to tie it again. So we're not tie it, we're gonna just put more pressure into it again. And we're gonna just put in one more knot again. Okay, yes, that's what you want, you see? And now, we're going to go ahead and take off those end pieces with your scissors, of course. Okay, so now I'm in the mood for some pink, and we're going to wrap that around like so. Again, make sure it's very, very tight. With the same method that I showed you earlier. There we go. See? That happened in just 5 seconds. There's no exact order that you can put your string in. I'm just putting those in the ones that I feel correctly. That I feel that would be awesome to look at the same time. So, again. again, there's no, I do repeat, there's no order at all whatsoever that you can abide by. You can be as creative as you want as well. So, after putting your strings all together, wrapping around, tying it like a knot, I'm just running into trouble here for some reason. There is this silver lining. A silver lining playbook doesn't seem to be working here with me. Yeah, but it's okay. We're gonna get this done. Y'all got nothing to worry about. Okay, so. Like so. I'm gonna go ahead and put that in. There's another cord. Not liking it as well. I thought this through. Mathematically, there shouldn't be any problem. Should put this at the top. He doesn't like that area. Yeah, maybe. That area is much more slippier than others. Definitely not a slip and slide. Look how tight that is. Pretty sure there shouldn't be any issue. Okay, so back to what I was mentioning before. What is needed is, yes, this is going to be your end result after you tie all the knots in place with your metallic yarn. This will be your end result. With that regards. Now what we're going to do here is that once you painted your golden corks, it takes about, say 5 to 10 minutes, depending on how many layers of paint you want to put on each cork. But this is the fun part, because what we're going to do is, again, inspired by Doctor Who, let's just go ahead and pick the piece that you want. And just go ahead and glue it. So we're going to use super glue. This is a product that I've been told that will do its job in 10 seconds or less. So it tells me to shake, so I'll shake. I'm not sure if we're going to use all of them. If not, then, you don't have to, but just need to find a piece that's flat. So it looks like there's some air issues going on. Okay. Well, it looks like the super glue. This was unexpected. It was like the super glue just dried itself out, which I was not expecting to happen. Anywho, that's why we have backup. Pretty sure it shouldn't be a problem to glue this onto that. So let's just go ahead and proceed. And I know that we have to hold it down for quite a number of seconds. So, just like that. You can give that mountainous effect if you want, but just like that. The pieces, the puddles of glue has to be very limited to its space. So you can either show it with or without a puddle of glue. It's completely up to you, to be honest. But that's what we're going to do all the way around. Oh, thank God for backups, that's for sure. This is the effect that you want, actually. You can either do it the same, or you can go with the small ones, but basically all of these little corks are gonna go around. I'm gonna go around just surround it, to be honest with you. There's no way, shape, or form that's needed. Just make sure you just glue it. So I'm going to go ahead and proceed. Either have a puddle or don't have a puddle, it's completely up to you, but it actually looks kind of awesome when it does have a puddle, to be quite honest. See, that's the effect that you want, which is something I envision. Now, you don't have to put it like all in one area. If you want to move it up, you can definitely move it up, but don't use that. Use one that's flat. Use a flat spot. That one is quite the So we're just gonna go ahead and put it just like that. Not gonna go anywhere. And so as you can tell, it's turning out to be quite the contraption. Repetition is key in this. Again, you have no limitation or anything of that nature where you can put the devices. Put the corks, I mean. Make sure that the glue gets stuck on. That's one thing that one must not worry about. Basically, just like that. And again, you don't have to use all of them. You can put some inside if you want. That's going to look even more cooler. So, you know, it's supposed to seem a bit off because it is off, to be honest. I think an hour of glue time would be much more sufficient. There's this big daddy gonna go. Let's just put that right there. Just like so. So I'm thinking of putting the smaller ones all the way at the top. Just like that. And the bigger ones down below. Just something I had in mind. Okay, so look at this now. Holy, this is turning out quite amazing, I must say. So what I'm going to do, fill the space at the top end. You don't want to leave anything inside, I just realized, because something fell. Oh man, something fell. Let's get to hold this down much more. Much more harder than. I'm surprised something has even fallen yet, but yeah. But we're going to surround this with the corks. Oh yes. I think the glue time is just enough. And you always want to choose the flat area to proceed. Anything that's bumpy or whatnot, it's not going to go accordingly. Just giving everyone a heads up. So that's one thing you have to worry about, is the side you choose. So obviously this part is the bumpy part. So I'm just going to remove that. Just place it on the other side. You really gotta get it in there, to be honest with you. I'm gonna double check each one. That's good. And you really gotta push it in there. At least hold it down for at least 10 to 20 seconds. Or 5 to 10 seconds. At least. this one. Pretty sure I chose the flat end before. Always double check and triple check. Double check and triple check. Always double check and triple check. As you can tell, you just want to make sure that each and every one is just glued accordingly. So let's go ahead. Put that in there. So it actually turned out better than I imagined though. The thing is that you don't want to have any blank areas, so you can try and spread out the corks around accordingly. While just looking at this, seems like I don't need to add anything else more to it. And make sure you just hold down for at least 10 to 20 seconds at least. That's the important part, is letting it dry, to be honest. Just like so. Looks like some corks will work and some corks will not. Wine top. Okay. So. Almost. Okay, we just have to just fill this gray area of space, and we'll be on our way again. You don't have to use all the corks, but you can if you want. Seems like the areas that are having the most issues are the ones with all the bumps on the corks. So make sure, again, as mentioned, choose the flat side of the cork, put the glue on both ends or on one end, and just hold for at least 10 to 20 seconds at least. almost done here. We're trying to use up every single one. Give it at least some drying time. But if not, you can always put a dryer over it. Like, use a dryer and just have the... See, look at this. Oh my god. This looks absolutely amazing. I have to say, you have to be very, very delicate at this point. With that regards. And do you see any blank areas? I see two. So it doesn't really matter which one you put it on. And voila. There you go. So this would be your end result. Looking very, very sci-fi, as you can tell. Just by implementing these corks, it gives that very reminiscent, ancient effect. Because this will be going on top. See, just doing that just gives it out. Gives the contaminant. Now, the last part here is actually kind of simple. I'm not going to put too much into place here. With this, all you're simply going to do is grab a handful and such. Just grab a handful and just place it inside as if it was a Christmas card. Present, but just place it inside like this. So once the individuals open up, then yeah, just place it as if you're putting together a Christmas present. You can have it like some shooting out and some shooting in. Oh yeah, make it look ancient. And there you go. This will be your end result. This is something that I've planned for about 3 days, and it looks like it went according to plan. And again, what I would just mention to you is that because I just put the glue on, is make sure that there is drying time. But yes. Just like that. And that would be your end result after 2 days of work. Yeah.